Perhaps your family is among the hundreds of mid-Americans who participate in the annual Christmas Day bird count. Since 1900, the Audubon Society organizes what has become the largest citizen-led ecological study. People designate a radius surrounding their farm pond, woods, or meadow, and report how many geese, eagles, herons, cardinals, and jays they find. December provides an important migratory window, but also this Christmas time away from the presents, food, and festivities allowed people to commune with silence on a winter morning surrounded by God's trimmings on the day Christ entered our world. Our natural life carries on as if COVID or any other human calamity does not exist. All is well. And as Jesus said, "Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet heavenly God feeds them. Are you not of more value than they?" You can count on that.
Some years ago, I was a guest in Worcester, Massachusetts at Christmas time. They call themselves the oldest fishing village in the United States, and everything about the culture, churches, the village, the people there revolves around the motif of fishing. Icons, doors, symbols, artwork, statues, people all have fish on them. It's easy to tell what has drawn them in and provided life and often caused death in their decades of being a seaside town. And there's no describing what a fresh caught lobster bought from a vendor positioned on the bay tastes like when steamed and eaten within hours of the catch. One cold night, we wandered downtown to observe the Christmas parade and tree lighting. As we approached town center, there stood the tree about 2.5 stories high, intricately built out of hundreds of rectangular shaped colorful lobster traps, and the tree was covered with oversized wooden ornaments that had once been floaters on a net hanging in the body of a fishing boat or floating in the sea. They too were painted bright colors by the children. Since that night, a Christmas tree has had a different shape and hue in my mind's eye. The image reminds me of those hardy, steadfast, hardworking village folk who used what they had to symbolize their joy and hope. If nothing else this Advent journey, remember that God comes to us where we are and loves us as we are. And it's just as simple and as complex as all of that.
And so, Mid-America disciples, you may be wondering, how can we rejoice in this year, 2020, the pandemic? But I found an interesting verse in Hebrews 12:2, which really seems to be on the surface an oxymoron, which says that Jesus, who for the joy that was set before him, endured the cross. And so I'm learning that joy and the ability to rejoice is not a feeling, but rather it is a gift that is set before us and allows us, as it allowed Jesus, to face any hardship, any pandemic, any loss. Just like that little boy with the loaves and fishes, he brought his gift of joy and God worked a miracle to feed 5,000 and more. Like the innkeeper who had no room in the inn, remembered a stable that he had available and he offered it to God and it brought him joy to usher in the light of the world. And so we say Merry Christmas to you, disciples of Mid-America Region. We pray for you, we love you, and may you truly rejoice. Amen.